Hi, I'm Paula Moore, the chiropractor, here to answer the most asked question I get in practice. Should I use ice or heat? And it's a great question. I always give the same answer to begin with. Go with your gut instinct. Your body knows best. If you can't bear the thought of ice touching your skin, then probably don't. If the thought of a hot water bottle or bath feels right, go with that to begin with. I think our instincts tell us a lot. Now for some of the rules. Let's talk about muscle tension. So you've been carrying your child on your shoulders through the weekend at the fairground, and your shoulders are really tense and sore, or you've been sitting too long at the computer, or you've been a couch potato all weekend. So you've got muscle tension. That's when you want to reach for the hot water bottle. I favor this to wheat packs because moist heat penetrates really quickly. Think a little bit of muscle tension squeezing around the blood vessels and constricting the blood flow to the area. Hot water bottle allows dilation of the blood vessels and increase of blood flow to the area, bringing more nutrients and more oxygen and washing away the waste products, the lactic acid from overworking muscles. Leaves you feeling much more comfortable quickly. Okay? Now, let's talk about inflammation. The kind of inflammation you get when you've injured yourself. You've slipped off a curb, maybe strained an ankle, knocked into a wall, you've got a bit of an egg on your forehead, or you've had a sudden back injury and it's very acutely painful. This is when we're talking now about acute pain, and this is when we talk about using ice. Acute pain is pain that lasts anywhere from day 1 up to day 7 to 10. And in this period, you'll have inflammation. Now, inflammation is the body's natural response to healing the area. So we don't want to stop inflammation. That's why I'm not a fan of anti-inflammatories. It's a drug, it's a chemical stopping the body's natural healing process. Without inflammation, our tissues wouldn't heal. So the ice is used more to get you feeling a little more comfortable in that period. So this is great. I love these gel packs, wrapped in a little tea towel. You can just pop them down your pants and walk around with them for 20 minutes at a time. And they don't get unbearably cold and they're flexible. So for the first 7 to 10 days, the acute pain that goes along with inflammation from an injury is going to be managed with ice. 20 minutes on, 1 to 2 hours off. 20 minutes on, 1 to 2 hours off. Do it at least 4 times in a day over that period. You'll probably already be seeing your health professional alongside that, and they'll also tell you the same. Now, after you get past the 1 week mark, you're going to start to alternate. Ice, heat, ice, heat. There'll still be some swelling, but the swelling doesn't feel like a water balloon so much now. It feels a bit more like hard gel, a bit like this pack actually. And now you can start increasing the blood flow to the area, because remember, increasing the blood flow dilates the blood vessels, brings more nutrients and oxygen to the area, important for healing. But there's still some discomfort, so you can manage the inflammation with using ice the way I initially told you to do, 20 minutes on, an hour or two off. Back and forth, again throughout the day, and you can do that for about a week. If you're getting into weeks of discomfort, weeks of pain, over the 4 week mark up to about 6 weeks plus, you're into chronic pain and you do need some help, to go and see your chiropractor. Don't try to manage it with ice and heat alone. It's not likely going to be enough. If you have any questions about that, please email me at posturevideos.com, and I hope that was really helpful. Thanks very much for watching. Bye.